Okay, so welcome.
Hvala vam, mi namete što ne full screen, to što se putim.
Aj. Okay, we will just put you in full screen and then we can begin.
Right, let me share my screen. Oh, for some reason, my computer doesn't allow me to allow recording.
Okay, I started recording with OBS Studio, so we don't need to record by Google Meet.
Okay. So, sure. Can you see my slides?
Yeah.
From the one, I'll start from there. Start from beginning. Okay. Is this a font? And because I can see from your side how it looks. Let me know if it's clear, visible.
Yeah, it's great.
Okay, so I'm going to start. And yeah, if you have any question in between this session, just let me know. We can have a discussion. Or if time allows, we might have some time in the end for me to answer any questions. So nice to meet you all, although I couldn't see you right now, I'm sorry. My name is Teresa. I'm a software engineer. I work for JP Morgan. And also I'm a Google developer expert. And since you are all in the Google community, you probably know that we're not expert in a way, but we talk and present and showcase lots of Google frameworks and their product. So today I'm going to talk about frontend and combine with Gemini, one of the Google latest new release of their AI generative AI tool. This is very informational. I won't show you any demo or coding. So hopefully you will enjoy the session. And yeah, if you have any questions, right, just let me know. So a bit of like overview of what we're going to talk today. I'm going to start with discussing a few of the keywords of what's AI, what's large language model, and then going to diving on generative AI and talk more about how this would impact front-end project. And I will also explain what the frameworks and product are there in the market you can use in your project. So let's begin with, let's go through some keywords, right? So if you are studying AI, or if you are in the AI field, you might be familiar with a few of those things. In case you're not from this background, right? Just overview, I'm not gonna read them through like word by word, but artificial intelligence is like the family of everything. It has four types, and we are not there yet in the self-aware of AI, but we are kind of using the power of AI to help us make decisions, to make predictions and perform tasks. So we are actually in a level, I'm not saying level, like type two or type three, but we're not there in yet, that AI doesn't have emotions at the moment. I couldn't say if it's a good thing or bad thing, but those are like four types of AI. And machine learning is a subset of AI. It actually made AI, implement AI, like made AI true in terms of how it came to computer science. Again, in terms of machine learning, there are also four types. Supervised learning, like something we are quite familiar with, like we can use the power of our computer or our phone to recognize image for us. That's supervised learning, that's how we train the model. And unsupervised learning, reinforced, and deep learning. So deep learning is what we're going to focus more today, because generative AI is more associated with deep learning. It's also, generative AI is a subset of deep learning. So going to a bit more on deep learning, there are two types of it, discriminative and generative. So discriminative we use it to classify, to predict. we train unlabeled data set. Narrative is something we use to generate new data to understand data distribution and predict as well. And what it means a bit more, right? So for deep learning, right, you will feed the model with data. At the same time, you will also label them. So for example, you will give like 1,000 of image to the model, and you would label those image, like for example, it's a flower or it's a dog. So you will actually label them, and you get give the you feed the data into the model, and you in the output you will have like a model you can use to predict flower image. On the other side, generative AI model, we will still feed in data to it. They're unstructured, not labeled, but this model will learn the pattern by itself. And at the end, the output is that this model is able to generate new content for you instead of making predictions. So they work in a very different way because we train them in a very different way. Right. And the power behind all this is large language model, because generative AI works in a way that it uses unstructured data, and it also generates new data because of that. It requires a like large language model to power itself. Right? It's like the power bank. So large language model, it's a large training data and a large number of parameters. It can recognize, translate, predict, and generate new content. Right. A bit more. So again, three types of it. Right. You don't have to memorize everything for now, but everything is. The content that I'll share them. So three types. You have generic language model. For example, when you write email or you write some document. And the tool you use can auto-complete the sentence for you. The model behind this is generative language model. And we have instruction tuned, right? We can use it to make predictions. And dialogue tuned, right? For special instructions. And we use this for like making a chat or talk to a bot, for example. This will have the special instructions. Now, so we have talked a bit like those keywords, right? AI, large language model, deep learning, right? On a very high level view. Let's go into generative AI, right? We'll talk about prompt transformers and a bit more of how things work behind the scene. So generative AI. So I couldn't see you right now. Usually ask like, have you used any tool yet? Tried the prompt? Have you tried the Gemini? Tried the ChatGPT? Right? Assuming you probably do or not. Right? Doesn't matter. For Gen AI, what it does is really requires input data, and has a model, and together they will have some output, right? How do we differentiate Gen AI or something that is not Gen AI, right? So with this formulate, right? If Y is a number, like the output is something like a number or class or probability, right? This is not Gen AI, but it's Gen AI when your output is a language, is image, is like something, it's a new content. So it has the capable of generating something new, right? So what do we mean by the output of Gen AI? We can use that for generate text for email marketing notes and the chat. We can generate image. We can generate code as well. And we will dive in a bit more about the code part, right? Because we talk about how Gen AI can help and accelerate front-end project. And we use it for voice recognition, video editing, and 3D models, gaming, audio, and many, many more, right? We just yet to discover and explore. So let's go back to a bit of technical right now, right? So there are three main parts in GenAI. You don't have to, again, if you found this like too much information at the moment, right, it's fine. We will talk a bit more on transformers. This is like, I would say, one of the very nice, very innovative product, right? Google actually designed and worked with, right? This actually made this whole GenAI become true, the transformers. It has two parts, right? It has encoder and a decoder. So encoder actually encodes input, and the decoder learns and decide the representation. And one of the example for transformers is like, for example, when we want to translate language, right, from English to Chinese or from English to French. So for example, if I want to say today is a nice day. When I translate this sentence into French or into Chinese, I couldn't just translate it word by word. Like I couldn't just translate today into Chinese language and is in Chinese language, because the order of all the words in other language will change. And we have to consider like some of the grammars and the plural forms and the past tense, all that in together. Each language have different grammars, right? So translation in this case will be very difficult, but with the power of using transformers, actually, and one of the things that they come up with a name is the attention. And with this tool together, they made the translation possible to actually translate language, like not word by word, but something meaningful from one language to a different language. And another thing in GenAI, like something you probably use and interactive more, is prompts, right? So if we use ChatGPT or Gemini, for example, we want to get some content on the output from ChatGPT or Gemini, we need to first give something to it, right? It's prompt, it's input or image or video or audio. It can be anything, right? It can be a question, can be a statement. And we create a prompt that something like should be very clear. And for prompt, this is how we get quality response, right, from your language model. Few ways that you can use to create good prompts, right? Make it clear, make it like a specific topic. Like you are talking to a friend, right? Start with something, hi, Gemini, can you tell me, I want to understand something, right? Like you are talking to someone. Use open-ended question to encourage discussion. And also in this moment, for example, Gemini, will remember the question that you asked in the first one. So for example, if your first question is to ask review about a movie, and you can ask the second question is to summarize your first review into a short sentence, right? It will memorize what you asked the first. And you need to provide a context, right, to make this more powerful response. And you can also define your output, right? The format you want, the language and the tone. For example, if you want to get the algorithm, if you want the output to be in Python or to be in Java, right? Just define the output. I've never done a topic, right? You want a definition, you want to an explanation, or you want to apply something to something, right? So those five steps will help you to create a very good prompt. So example, right? Can you create, right? Like if you're talking to someone, can you create the code of sorting numbers, right? By ascending order in Python. So I narrow down the context. I ask specifically this is algorithm and the language is Python, right? And so on, right? So try this out. You can try using different prompt on same topic, and you will notice that, right? With different prompt you use, you will get different output as well. This is actually quite fun to compare how the language model works. So how do we use the power of GenAI to create a better code, right? So it provides both useful and unuseful for sure. It writes algorithm. We can use it to make some summary of the page content. But again, right, don't trust everything it writes, verify it. It doesn't deliver the entire project for you, but you can use it to explore some libraries and resources. Now let's dive into front-end project. So imagine, like, because I work for the fintech industry, so imagine we are making a fintech application, right? Maybe a mobile application for a banking, for trading, right? For stock markets, right? And in general, those fintech applications will consist of lots of components, right? Like authentication, we'll have authentication, user management. And you have your user, your KYC, your customer support, your notifications, right? Your emails to the user. And it has testing, CICD, and automation. And you have your project, you have like account and profile management. And connections to backend service, your API calls, and how do you release your application, your deployment, and how you monitor it, right, for any feedbacks. So those are like a very high-level view of what is in the front-end project. But at the same time, what Jin couldn't do for you, for your project, right, as for today, because things change a lot. It doesn't provide you a project design. It doesn't automate things for you. It provides like content, right? But it doesn't automate everything for you, like your CICD pipeline, your testing automation. It doesn't scale for you. So for example, you have to go into different language, apply accessibility, tools configurations, right? It also doesn't maintain the project for you. But how to actually use the power of AI in front-end project, right? Let's think about any project, right? Not just front-end project. Any project, any computer science, right? Or any IT project. There are two parts of it, right? One is user experience. It's how your user use your project. How user interact with your project. And another part is dev experience, right? How developer use this tool to accelerate my work, right? So those are actually separate parts. So user experience, right? AI can actually use like AI-powered chatbot, right? To help with making a better front-end project with voice image recognition, customized, personalized content, dynamic and intelligent user interface. In terms of dev experience, right, we have, like, for example, auto code generation and the completion translations between code, language, and do code review and the pair debugging. So how do we take advantage, right, of the current frameworks and the product we have to help us like reach user experience and accelerate us creating front-end projects, right? So OpenAI, right, ChatGPT, this was introduced, the version one of GPT was introduced back in 2018. And the version one has 170 million of parameters compared to what we have as today. We have very powerful language model, like companies don't even reveal how many parameters they have now in the model. It's probably very large. And in 2022, OpenAI introduced ChatGPT. ChatGPT is the front-end project of OpenAI that uses the power of GPT. And 50 million users, right? They just generate so many users in the first month. It's a web tool. And you can use GPT to see, hear, and speak, right? You can chat with language, voice, and image. And later on, released the Sora. Sora is an AI model that creates a very realistic image, right? videos, right, from text instructions. This is very powerful. So for example, right, this is what you can see from the tool of Sora. Depends on the depends on the computer language you use, right? The base one or the more advanced one or the actually very powerful one, you get higher resolutions, right? It understand language. It's always improving, right? And at the same time, in terms of what we have from Google, right? Google also released Gemini, and recently they also announced Gemini 1.5. And what this does, right? It has 1 million token context window. What it means is, instead of giving like a language or sentence as prompt, you can give your prompt. The size of it can be 1 million token. So you can actually give like an entire project of a book, like Lords of the Rings, and ask Gemini to give you like a summary of those books. You can give them like a very like 11 hours of audio, 1 hour of video, to ask Gemini to analyze this content for you. And this is actually really, really, really powerful, right? So this is an example of what Gemini can create for you as an image. Right. So in addition, right, the current Gemini model is a multi model. So it actually and you can actually give it like a text and image combined. So I think Gemini 1.5 is not public yet, but luckily I have like early access to give it a try. I signed up for the to be the testing group, right? So they give me early access. So going to Gemini 1.5 is actually the UI looks very similar compared to 1 and the 1.5. The only addition thing that I can see right now is Gemini 1.5. It has like the session for you to upload a video, right? So you can upload a video. And what it looks like is, for example, I upload a video here, right? And this is actually a very long video, 30 minutes. And you can see the number of tokens here. Right? It's not 1 million yet, but it tells you how many tokens it has. And in the end, it actually tells me very quickly, right, what the content of this video is. And imagine the computer power behind all this, right? It's very powerful. So how can we use all this, right, to accelerate our front-end project? Right, this now, let's go back to talk a bit more about the dev experience, right? So there's like lots of tools right now around the project that Google will release is the IDX. Again, if you want to try it, you can ask for early access as well as a testing, for testing purpose, right? They open the waiting list and they actually will slowly grab people in to try this out. It's very similar, I would say similar-ish to what GitHub has for CodePen. It's a browser-based IDE. You can use it to generate code completion, error correction, collaboration, and also a translate language for you. Not from English to French, but from Python to Java, from Java to JavaScript. And also, it also gives you the highlights of possible license requirements based on this tool you generate, right? It tells you whether or not the code you use is open source, for example. So I created like a very quick project with IDE tool. As you can see, so this, if you use the VS Code before, the UI looks very much like VS Code, but in addition, you have this Power BI, right? You can use it to explain your code, add comments, and do something with your code, right? And it creates your UI straight away in a web browser. So when you want to, and again, right, those tools can help you to improve your dev experience. But when it comes to, when you want to create an application that has the power of AI, again, you can try the, for example, one of the tools you can use is the Vertex, right? Vertex AI Studio. You can use it to do prompt design tooling for data science, data scientists. And there's another a product underneath the Vertex AI is the model garden. You can use it to train your models, pre-train your models, right, for machine learning developers, right? So how the tool looks like, right? If you go to Vertex AI Studio, it's cloud-based tool, and you can use for prototyping, for testing your AI models, right? You can test to prompt design and test your models and the tool models, right? Design prompts and convert between speech and the text, right? So this is a view of what the tool looks like in a Google Cloud family. You can use this tool to build applications for, like, for a notes app, a recipe app, some advert form video. You can generate some FAQ, make a movie review app as well. You can also create a gym trainer, right? So, like, for example, if you wanted to train yourself, right, you ask for personal trainers, right? You can also save, like, you can make a video of yourself, right? Maybe play tennis, maybe running, and ask Gemini to let you know if your body gesture is the standard, right? Or how you can improve. And in addition, on top of all this, Google also announced the Gemma open models. This is actually open source, but they call this open models because they think open models describe this open source of Gemma better. It's AI models for everyone to use as open source. It's a family of lightweight open models developed by Google. It has different size, and you can run on your workstation or cloud, right? So you can use models, right, from other people, and you can also train them within this tool. So a bit a summary, right? How AI and frontend, what's impact, right? So remember, right, use the power of AI, it increase the efficiency, it personalize user experience and improve accessibility and the code reusability at the same time, right? It doesn't understand the full context of your product. It might have bias. It might be lack of creativity and innovation. So you will still be the one that provides all those things to it, right? The risk analysis, the security, some challenges, and think about the cost as well. So Gen AI is very powerful, but always, right, use it with responsible. Use it with responsibility to enhance, not to replace, with human expertise. So thank you for listening. So this is all my presentation. And if you have questions, we can discuss a bit here, or you can send me messages from my LinkedIn or from my Twitter. Yeah. So thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so we don't have questions for now. We will share your LinkedIn profile so they can shoot you messages if they need to.
Yeah.
Thank you for this presentation. And could you maybe send the presentation via email so we can share it with our guests here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's give a round of applause to Therese.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you. Bye.
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 Ok, ljudi, sad imamo malo dužu pauzu, sat i po vremena, pošto niko ne ima ništa da pita. Oh, she got cherry lips, angel eyes. She knows exactly how to tantalize. She's
he's out to get you, danger by design. Cold-blooded vixen, she don't compromise. She's something mystical in colored lights. So far from typical, but take my advice. Before you play with fire, do think twice. And if you get burned, don't be surprised. Got me lifted, drifting higher than the ceiling. Ooh, baby, it's the ultimate feeling. You got me lifted, feeling so gifted. Sugar, how you get?